form a thought that would adequately describe the greatness of my God. And my lungs had not yet developed the ability to release breath with enough agility to breathe out the greatness of His love. And my voice is so inhibited, restrained by human limits, that it's hard to even send a praise up. If there are words for Him, I don't have them. My God, His grace is remarkable. Mercies are innumerable. Strength is impenetrable. He is honorable, accountable, and favorable. Unsearchable, yet knowable. Indefinable, yet approachable. Indescribable, yet personal. He is beyond comprehension, further than imagination, constant through generations, King over every nation. But if there are words for Him, I don't have them. You see, my words are few, and to try to capture the one true God using my vocabulary would never do, but I use my words as an expression of worship to a Savior who is both worthy and deserving of my praise, so I use words. My heart extols the Lord, blesses His name forever. He has defeated me in my rebellion. He has conquered me in my sin. He has welcomed me into His presence, completely inviting me in. He has made Himself the object of my sight, flooding me with mercies in the morning and drowning me with grace in the night. But if there are words for Him, I don't have them. What I do have is good news. For my God knew that man-made words would never do. For words are just tools that we use to point to the truth. So He sent His Son, Jesus Christ, as the Word, living proof. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For by Him, all things were created, giving nothingness formation. And by His word, He sustains in the power of His name. For He is before all things and over all things. He reigns. Holy is His name. So praise Him for His life, the way He persevered in strife, the humble Son of God, becoming the perfect sacrifice. Praise Him for His death, that He willingly stood in our place, that He lovingly endured the grave, that He battled our enemy, and on that third day, He rose in victory. He is everything that was promised. Praise Him as the risen King. Lift your voice and sing, for one day He will return for us, and we will finally be united with our Savior for eternity. So it's not just words that I proclaim, for my words point to the Word, and the Word has a name. Hope has a name. Joy has a name. Peace has a name. Love has a name, and that name is Jesus Christ. Praise His name forever. alive, everything changes. The areas where you thought there was no hope, there's hope. Because Jesus is alive. When you feel disenfranchised and marginalized, and you feel no one loves you, all that changes because Jesus is alive. And His love is unconditional. His love can't be earned or bought or bartered. And you just receive it today as a free gift. Amen. Hope has a name. Because Jesus is alive, everything changes. Lord, we pray that the power of Your Holy Spirit, the power of the resurrected Jesus, would course through our lives, not by our efforts, but by receiving the gift, the free gift, letting You live Your life through us, effortlessly. Jesus, we love You. We praise You. Lord, we are captivated by You. Worthy, worthy is the Lamb. Amen, amen. God bless you. Have an awesome week. Jesus is alive. Hope has a name. Amen. Praise God. Let's give Him a hand.